அறியா பதறியாம் நித்யானந்தா ஓதி பாடிடும் வரம் அளித்தே குறைதனை களைந்தாய் கணம் தனில் நித்யானந்தா அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல குரு நித்யானந்தா அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல குரு நித்யானந்தா பணிந்தோம் நித்யானந்தா மனம் தாண்டிய மலை மகனே புயலன புகுந்தாய் மனம் தனில் நித்யானந்தா அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல குரு நித்யானந்தா அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல குரு நித்யானந்தா இக வாழ்வே பெரும் பிணிதானன உணர்ந்தே புனை அடைந்தோம் நித்யானந்தா ஜகமாயையில் இருந்தமை மீட்டே தடுத்தாட்கொண்டிடுவாய் நித்யானந்தா அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல குரு நித்யானந்தா அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல குரு நித்யானந்தா அகங்காரம் மதன் வினைவாய் யுகங்களாய் பிறந்தே தவித்தோம் நித்யானந்தா நிலையானது ஆன்மாவென உணர்ந்துந்தன் பதம் சரண் புகுந்தோம் நித்யானந்தா அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல குரு நித்யானந்தா அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல குரு நித்யானந்தா எதிராய் புரிந்திந்த புவி மேல் நீதம் வந்த அகந்தையில் உழன்றோம் நித்யானந்தா கதிராய் நிலைதனை எரித்தே வழி தரும் ஒளியாய் மலர்ந்தயம் நித்யானந்தா அருணாச்சல நித்ய அருணாச்சல நித்ய
Listen, if you are able to see me, hear me, please wave your hands. Listen. The basic principle I want to explain is in every aspect of life, all these 36 principles are different aspects of life. Today, I am giving you an example of Kala Tattva, time principle. How an unconscious, ordinary human being, how they grasp time. Maximum they are able to grasp only these three units of time: earth rotating itself making one day, chandra moon going around the earth making one month, earth going around the sun making one year. Only these three basic units of time unconscious human mind is able to grasp. But the consciousness which could center itself in nirvikalpa samadhi, superconscious state, finds he is centered in Mahakailasa, this whole Surya Mandala is going around the Mahakailasa, makes the fourth unit of time called Kalpa. Listen. When you don't understand the fourth unit of time, Kalpa, you start developing very narrow vision about time, life, about everything. Anyone, even intellectually, understands the concept of Kalpa, the fourth unit of time, is liberated from so much of fears. I tell you, the permanence of existence, perception about life absolutely changes the moment you understand this fourth unit of time. I'm just revealing some of the superconscious principles. I want a long Vakyartha Sadas to happen in every level. Understand? Because we are agitated, we don't think for a long time, because we don't think or try to understand the multiple units of time. We are just stuck with three units of time. That is why all our planning, all our ability to connect with the time, all our ability to understand time stops with the units of years. Whether you calculate for 10 year or 10 million year, whole thing is just within the unit called year. But if you understand the fourth unit of time, Kalpa or Yuga, the whole realization about you, life, everything will change. The sin of one life theory will lose its base. I call it a sin because of that one life theory. So much suffering for humanity. See, whether the greedy way of generating the wealth by destroying the earth, it's like you are going to attend a competition, bodybuilding competition tomorrow, just to get the award or the winner title. You take steroids and show the muscles which is not really built by hard work. Through steroids or drugs, you are ready even to die day after tomorrow after winning the title. But somehow you want to win the title. How unconscious human beings can go? You see, anyone when they start gymming and building muscles, the purpose is health. But when they get addicted to it and greedy about it, they are ready to die to win the title, to win the competition. How unconsciousness turns the whole purpose. Same way, Wealth is for living happily long time. But when you become too greedy, you are ready to even compromise on the security of the planet Earth, safety of the planet Earth. Why do you think there's so much of carbon release and global warming, and still we are not bothered about protecting the Earth? The greed for the wealth, luxury, has made man forget the security of the planet Earth. Understand? Whatever I am talking, I am revealing the principles of superconsciousness. If you do Vakyartha Sadas, you will understand. In individual life, social life, political life, and international levels, in how many ways the unconscious understandings of human beings is creating confusion. I tell you.
Nitya Shankara, Nitya Nanda Shankara.
Listen. I tell you. Listen to these basic truths. Understanding the fourth unit of the time will give you understanding about life and tremendous joy, ecstasy, fulfillment that you are going to be here for a long time. I tell you, this ability to grasp the fourth unit of time comes to you when you bring tremendous shanti in you. I sincerely request all Hindus, all my disciples who trust me, bring more and more peace inside you. I can give you 5 major techniques to bring peace inside you. 1, unclutching. Nothing like unclutching to bring peace in you. 2, chant Vedic Upanishads and Suktas. Chanting of the Vedic Upanishads and Suktas will bring loud chanting. See, when you chant loudly, the broken thought current stuck in your system, which is responsible for tiredness, depression, unknown illogical behaviors of you. The unknown illogical behaviors of you is due to the broken, irrational, junk thought current sitting inside you, like an undigested food. If you take Haritaki, all the undigested food will leave you and you will be free. Same way, if you chant loudly the Vedic Upanishads and Suktas, all the broken, depressing, illogical thought currents will leave you. You will experience shanti, peace. 3, intense ajapa-japa. 4, little romantic but very powerful, feeling connection with Guru, intense feeling connection with Guru. When you have a deep feeling connection with Guru, just listening to his words or songs on him, about him, by him, or seeing his form, any activity related to feeling connection will bring tremendous shanti, peace. 5, listen carefully. listen very carefully. First, unclutching. Second, chanting of the Vedic Upanishads and mantras and suktas. Third, ajapa, japa. Fourth, feeling connection. Fifth, any power manifestation. If you sit in oneness and do any power manifestation, you will add so much shanti in you, understand? Adding shanti tattva inside you, building shanti tattva inside you, just like building muscles, building shanti tattva is a spiritual practice. Building muscles is a physical practice. Building shanti tattva is the spiritual practice. You can start doing. The shanti tattva will make you realize the fourth unit of time. Time and thought currents is closely related. If you have the high TRP, high number of thoughts per second, you will feel like time is not moving at all. You will, if you are in absolute peace, you will feel like time, oh God, days have disappeared. And you are in ecstasy. Listen. So your inner space, shanti, and your ability to grasp the higher units of time is closely connected. The thoughts per second, TPS, and your ability to grasp time is highly connected. Especially Kayakalpa Yoga students, this is the important lesson you need to know. You need to cognize the fourth unit of time for you to master Kayakalpa. Listen, the idea you have about time is responsible for certain chemicals to be released in your body. If you understand the fourth unit of time, a unique special chemical released inside your body that is called Amrita. See, all the gods and demons going around the Meru Mandara, the Meru Hill, the Mahakailasa, understanding the time through the Vasuki snake. Vasuki is nothing but the symbolic representation of the time snake, Kala Sarpa. When that happens, the body releases nectar. Understand? The understanding I am giving now, the vast understanding about the fourth unit of time, if you can intellectually internalize and see in your life, suddenly you will realize you have so many powerful cognitions, so many powers, so many wonderful things in life. Understand, this whole Kailasa I am farming to keep at least in one place on the planet Earth the cosmic law. Cosmic law as country law. Cosmic principles as the country's principles. I am a person, will do what I want. I I'll do what I want. Nothing can be done about it. You call that as arrogance or pride, or I don't care about any of your definitions. I just know what I am carrying is Satya Sangalpa. I will do what I want. I will make Kailasa on planet Earth. The Mahakailasa's principles will be the principles of this country. The laws of Mahakailasa will be the laws of this country. No one can stop it. I will do it. And show it. Only then people will understand what I am trying to do, or what I am planning to manifest. I'll do it now. See, I tell you, whatever you know about me till now, everything is delusion. Because I have to make strategies, plans, decisions based on the country where I was living, based on their law, their society, how human minds react to that laws, that society. Based on that, I have to strategize, plan, react, respond. Any idea you developed about me, based on my action, reaction, responses, everything is delusion, because all of that is not me. That is the response for your country's laws, your society's actions, reactions, the way your unconscious mind is trained. For that, what best response I can give, I have given. Only now in Kailasa, you are going to see the real me. Whatever you have seen me is reaction to your society. Unfortunately, I have to be with unconscious society in the initial days of my manifesting of Kailasa. So anything you know, whether you have incompletion about my policies, my reactions, actions, principles related to economy or the work or human beings or relationships, anything you know is delusion. Now in Kailasa, only I am going to really demonstrate who I am and manifest the real me, Paramashiva. I tell you, the country where I was living, naturally, at any situation, at any given point, I have to act or react or respond based on those countries, society's laws. And people who come to me also, they are bound by those laws, principles, ideas. For example, in Adi Kailasa, working more was expected as lifestyle. But in Kailasa, sitting more is going to be expected as a lifestyle. The more you sit unclutched, the more you are going to be glorified. Because we just need 10,000 human beings to sit, unclutch and radiate that intense shanti. The intense shanti into the universe. to nullify the collective negativity. We need more gods for planet Earth, less human. But unfortunately, in Indian society, when you don't work, you only fall into tamas. Your body is strained. The food, thought currents, lifestyle, everything. Either you are active or sleeping, confused, lethargic, depressed, not in Turiya. But the food style, lifestyle, everything in Kailasa will be, you are unclutched, unclutched, unclutched. The more you are unclutched, more intensely active you are. More you are in Turiya, more active. More you are in Turiya Atita, more strategically active. Lifestyle, food style, everything. And understandings about life. I tell you, just this one principle, understanding the fourth unit of time. I am not even explaining the whole Surya Siddhanta. Surya Siddhanta explains not only the unit of Kala, there is something called where the Kala takes turn. Means, Kala is described as the serpent eating its own tail. Snake eating its own tail continuously. That eating, how it just pulls its tail and swallows, that is called happening, event. I'll give you a small understanding about these events of time. Like how I explained the units of time, listen to the event of time. Earth rotates itself. Moon not only goes round the earth, it also rotates itself. Earlier I said moon was kept as a satellite and it doesn't rotate for a different purpose, for a different understanding. Later on I'll talk about that, why I made that statement. The comparative parameters with which I was comparing, there it was different, and now the statement I am making is different. Don't be confused. Now listen to this statement, then you will understand this whole principle I am trying to explain. Earth moves, rotates itself and goes round the sun. Same way, moon rotates itself and goes round the earth, and sun rotates itself and goes round the Mahakailasa. In this movements, listen carefully, the unit of time is dependent on the actions. Events of time is this self-rotation and going around another body, criss-crossing of that is event. For example, because moon goes round the earth and earth is going around the sun, this crisscrossing is the eclipse. At one point, this crisscrossing happens, means sun is covered by the moon or moon is covered by the sun. This crisscrossing, that is called events, eclipses, same way, sun rotating itself and going around the Mahakailasa creates multiple events, not just unit. It creates multiple events. Now, I'll only give you the basic understanding about the events. I will reveal the events of Kala Tattva later. Now, understand the units of Kala Tattva and also understand how, by not understanding the units of Kala Tattva, we are all collectively suffering and started believing suffering is natural. No! Suffering is neither natural nor inevitable. Hey, with the right understandings, it doesn't even exist. The visionaries are convinced suffering is inevitable. So the followers are also convinced suffering is inevitable. That is the biggest suffering. That is the real delusion. That is the real delusion. Units of time and events of time. In Surya Siddhanta, snake eating its own tail, every swallowing is considered as event. A full snake body eaten by itself is called unit. So for earth rotating itself, there's a unit and events. Moon rotating itself, there is unit and events. Moon going around the earth, there is unit and events. Earth going around the sun, there is unit and events. Sun going around the Mahakailasa, there is unit and events. Now, let us look at only the fourth unit of time. The fourth unit of time is cognized by the mind which lives in Nirvikalpa Samadhi. And even if all of you have not achieved the Nirvikalpa Samadhi, if you understand the principles from a person who lives in Nirvikalpa Samadhi and makes that as a lifestyle, you will enjoy all the benefits of the Nirvikalpa Samadhi. For example, Einstein's theory, all of us may not understand, but many benefits derived from that theory we are all enjoying in our life because we decided to accept his theories. Same way, the fourth unit of time, this theory, all of you may not be able to grasp it, but if you decide to accept and enjoy, make this theory as a part of you, you will enjoy all the benefits of these truths, benefits of this theory. That is what I call living enlightenment. Till you realize personally, individually, as your own enlightenment, living it because your guru has revealed it, making that as your vision, because your guru has revealed it, is living enlightenment. I tell you, if you have intense feeling connection with guru, celebrate, you are a blessed one. Because so many realizations, without you waiting to achieve, you will start getting the benefits of it. You will start reaping the benefits of Guru's realizations without you waiting to achieve it personally. See, you not enjoying the benefits till you reach that space personally is waste of time. Till you understand all the principles of electricity, if you say I will not use fan or air cooler or heater or lights, you are a fool. You learn, no doubt, learning is good, encouraged, but till you learn, don't say I will not use the benefits, I will not enjoy the benefits. So you should get enlightened, but don't be fooled to tell till I am enlightened I will not enjoy the benefits of the enlightened realities and truths and principles. Enjoying the benefits and realities and principles, all the benefits of enlightenment even before personally achieving it due to your trust on the Guru is living enlightenment, Jivan Mukti. Let's do Vakya Sadasan, this fourth unit of time, Yuga, Kalpa. I'll continue in the further satsangs. Sorry for the technical glitch in between. Actually, I left the jetta open, but only after a few minutes I realized only if the jetta is there as the weight on my head, I am able to be very grounded and able to talk to all of you continuously. Without the jetta weight on the head, just system shoots up into samadhi. That's the reason I tied the jetta and started the satsang again. So with this, I bless you all. Let's all move to Paramashiva Ganas session. And I also want to thank all the volunteers, Kailashians who are sincerely working in Paramashiva Gana projects. Even though I am not sitting every day for the all the sessions, see, somebody working when I am actively following up is different. But so many of you are sincerely working knowing that I am in Samadhi, even though I am not following up. I am not attending to all the meetings. I am not following up with everyone. I am in samadhi, but you are sincerely working. That is the extreme chastity. Understand? When the king is in palace, you being chaste is not something great. That is a lifestyle. But when the king has gone for some hunting or a war, in those days they go for Tirtha Yatra or the hunting or war or some purposes. At that time also, when you are chaste, that's a real, absolute, pure dedication. So all those volunteers, Paramashivganas, who are sincerely working, I am seeing such large amount of work is happening. The Hinduism PDI is ready, which is going to be released on Vijayadashami day. Earlier I planned for 100,000 page, thanks to Hinduism PDI team. They already crossed 1 million page now. It's ready. I actually thought the Hinduism PDI, we will release it with 100,000 page on Vijayadashami and then start building in next 2 years. I wanted to make it as a million pages and down the lane 5 years at least billion page. We should be the largest wiki resource for Hinduism. That was my plan. But the team has worked so sincerely. Hats off to all Hinduism PDI team. I'm so happy you guys did it. Already we have crossed million page. We have not even published it. Crossed million page and whole thing is legally, properly collected without violating any copyright. Everything is legitimate. If somebody has copyrighted, we approach them and get them to give us the copyright. Or if they have declared that they don't have a copyright and anyone can use it, we acknowledge them, properly give our gratitude to them for making that material available to us. Everything is very organized, systematic, legitimate, which will be up for Vijayadashami. So now I am feeling within next 2 years we can make it into billion pages. Because we already crossed million, we can make it into billion pages, because the scriptures we collected is not yet added in this million page. That is there another 20 million books. In that we are now working with every publisher, getting copyright, all that legal work is going on. If all that is done properly, we will be easily crossing billion page. Thanks to the team which is working all over the world sincerely, intensely. Even though I am not personally following up or managing, even though I am in samadhi, thanks to your chastity, absolute commitment and chastity, and sincerely working, even while I am in samadhi, I tell you, whoever is working for Kailasa, when I am in samadhi, all the gifts I get from Kailasa belongs to you, will be showered on you, all the auspiciousness, energy, blessings, everything goes to you. And blessings to everyone who is actively part of building Kailasa, making Kailasa happen. So with this, I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhatvaita Saivam, the state, space, powers, being, superconsciousness and Kailasa of Paramashiva. Paramashivoham, Om Nityananda Paramashivoham, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.